was curious when you made the connection to World War II, how you made that. That's such a huge metaphorical connection that you make.
Yeah, it's hard to talk about metaphors because, you know, for me, film is metaphor. With no metaphor, images are just images and they just die. You know, we would make film with bank cameras, otherwise, no. So it's important that behind every image there is a metaphor. And I think Samuele in himself is carrying on metaphor constantly. His inner world is incredible. And we can talk about that. He's my guideline. Before I start shooting anything else, Samuele was the first person I was following. He became my emotional guide for the rest of the film, for the migrant, for all the rest. So it was very important to create this world of suspension, of interior, of something very strong. Dr. Bartolo also, no? He represents somehow the awareness in the film. And your metaphor was related to?
Well, I was also curious about making the comparison to World War II.
Yeah, which is the title of the film, Fuoco a Mare. And Fuoco a Mare is a song, the one you hear in the film, that is almost a hymn in the island. Everybody, it was another encounter I had in the island. This music was everywhere, in the fish market, in the morning, the things. They're like truck passing by with this music. And it catches you immediately. You know, you wake up in the morning singing this song. And when I was at the radio, and then I started asking about this song, and it came out that was related to a tragedy that happened in the Second World War. And Fuoco a Mare is the title of this song. And it's a very light song related to a big tragedy that happened in the Second World War, where a ship was bombed by a British airplane. La Maddalena was the ship. So the whole island was on fire, and there was many, many people die. And this song was somehow related to this tragedy again. But what I loved about it is the lightness of this music, which is very easy to sing, related to a big tragedy, which in a way I always try to keep this element in my work, you know, the lightness, and then somehow also go in moments which are very tragic and very, very heavy, which is death somehow in my film.